Hi guys, it's me Otter Draws and welcome back to my channel. So this week is random video week, and I thought, because if you're watching this when I post the video, you probably already know about the pandemic that is happening in the world, and I feel like a lot of people have a lack of motivation because they're in most of the cases stuck in their homes or just in general. So I thought I would do this video, which is tips on organizing your life, getting motivated, and all that kind of stuff. And if you're in the future, it's probably funny to look at the miserable humans that we are or we were these days. But yeah, let's get to the video. Okay, so my first tip would be, maybe the most important one, keep everything in one place. It's gonna save you a lot of forgotten tasks, and it'll be easier for you to remember and just have more organized life, I guess. Okay, so this is my DIY bullet journal. In my country, you don't really have bullet journals, so I had to make my own. But it's basically with all the monthly spreads and basically everything that you need. I don't know, this is the key symbols page. Okay, so with bullet journals, it's great because you can have a lot of creativity and freedom and everything that you might need to relax and stuff, but it is a bit more time consuming. So if you aren't really the type who is artsy and can put some time into decorating a bullet journal, then I don't really recommend it. But if you are, then the bullet journal is for you. You can also use an agenda or online apps, or not online, apps in general. And for example, for the online part, I use Zenidoo. It's good, I really like it, but yeah, if you want something that is pre-made and you don't have to carry an agenda or a notebook around with you, then yeah, online is great because I'm guessing that you're gonna carry your phone with you anyways, so yeah, that's easy to carry, and you also don't have to decorate or write, or it's easier, it just takes shorter for you to plan and be able to be organized. So yeah, those are kind of my options. Also, do not think that I'm an organization god, because I am not. Each one of these tips that I'm saying in this video, I mostly don't follow them. I mean, I know that they're useful and they do work. It's just that my brain does not accept them in some situations. So do not feel the pressure that they have to work for you. It's very possible that they won't, and you should just search for others. There might be some that work, some that don't. It depends on your lifestyle, it depends on you in general. So don't worry if they're not for you, because I guess I have all these hacks and they're not all even for me. It's complicated, so just find the ones that work for you, and there's no point in trying to get organized if it's not pleasant, or if it's hard, or if you take it as a chore. So yeah, organizing should be a pleasure, should be something that makes your life easier, not harder. My second tip would be, do not overplan. I tend to do that a lot when I feel more unmotivated, or I just feel like if I plan more, I'm probably gonna do the things more, but I won't. I will just spend more time on organizing and less time on actually doing the stuff. So do not overplan. My third tip would be find the perfect workspace. Maybe, you probably have seen this rule by this point, but don't work on your bed because that's where you sleep, and it might affect your sleep, the fact that you work in your bed, and the brain thinks that this is where I work, so it might think that about what you have done throughout the day. That's why you should change the space that you're working in and the space that you're sleeping in. But maybe go outside if you have a backyard, or make your desk space pretty or decorated, or make it nice for you. Just find somewhere that you enjoy working and it's relaxing you and all that kind of stuff. My fourth tip, which is not really a tip, just have a positive mindset and don't expect so much from you. I mean, you're human. Everybody makes mistakes and everybody is not productive all the time. You won't be productive every day. You'll have days that you'll be very productive, and you'll have days where you just lay in bed and stay on your phone. And that's normal. That's what humans do. So don't be mad on yourself just because you weren't productive in one day. My fifth tip would be make things rewarding, or at least if you're an artist, then when you do bullet journaling, if you like drawing or painting or coloring, then bullet journal is something that you will probably enjoy because you have to draw in it and color it in and all that kind of stuff. But also, for example, if you have, I don't know, 10 tasks in a day, that's quite a lot, but I'm just gonna use it as an example. For example, if you do 5 tasks, then give yourself something, like go out or eat candy, or all that, something that you enjoy, or makes you feel better, or makes you relaxed. That's what I mean. Also, take breaks, because everybody needs breaks. If you're just gonna work for a few hours straight, your brain is gonna be so tired, and you're gonna feel really bad after it. Also, depends on where you're staying. If you're staying at your desk, your back will hurt very much. So, take breaks. For example, there's the Pomodoro method, which is basically 25 minutes you're working and then 5 minutes you're on a break. And then after 4 of these cycles, you take a longer break for, I don't know, 15 minutes or even longer. So, take breaks because they're really helpful, even if they seem like you're wasting time or anything like that. You're not wasting time. You're just gonna be more productive after them. Your brain is not gonna be as tired, so you're gonna be even faster working. So you're gonna catch up those 5 minutes you were on a break, and you're gonna use them really more comfortably, and it's helpful, believe me. And my next tip would be, if you want to have a better day, if you're, I don't know how to explain it, but sit down and try to think of an ideal routine. For example, a morning routine, if you want to work out or stretch in the morning or do yoga or whatever, then think, at 8:30 I will wake up, then at 8:40 I will eat, or whatever. Think of a perfect routine, even if you don't always follow it. Just have it there, and occasionally you will follow it eventually, and you know, it might be helpful for you. And yeah, I've tried this and it doesn't always work for me. Like, I follow it for a few days, but then I get bored. But it's still good to have as a basic structure of what you want your morning to look like. And a few elements maybe you can actually do and follow. And that's how you can achieve a perfect morning, or perfection, it doesn't exist, but you know what I mean. So those were my tips on organizing your life. I hope some of them work for you. If they don't, then I'm sorry, but there's plenty of organizing tips out there, so you can research and maybe find your own. But and also, don't forget about the Instagram account, and I have probably some type of drawing or list of these tasks written more nicely over there. So if you want the list written down, I guess you can go over there and check it out. Link will be in the description down below. Anyways, leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Maybe consider subscribing and turning on that bell notification thing so you'll get notified when I post a new video. And I'll see you next time. Bye.